Today's lecture is continuation of previous lecture. I'll discuss today about Z statistics with respect to sampling distribution. So yesterday we discussed about Z statistics. Z statistics for variable A is equal to the difference between the value, a particular value of a variable, and mean of that variable divided by square root of variance, that is divided by the standard deviation. What is sampling distribution? If from a particular population we take more than one sample, then there will be mean of each sample. If we make a frequency polygon or frequency distribution of those means, this is mean of third sample, this is mean of second sample, this is mean of first sample, and this is mean of fourth sample. So if we plot the frequency distribution of those means, it will again be a bell-shaped curve, and at the middle, that is at the corresponding to the peak of that frequency distribution, will be the population mean. And when you go away from the population mean, let us say for a distance of one standard error, then you will have 68% of those means. And if you go beyond two standard error from the population mean, you will cover 95% of the means of the samples. So this distribution of the means of various samples from a particular population is known as sampling distribution. Yesterday we talked about the Z statistics for a single sample. Now we are talking about multiple samples, more than one samples taken from the population, and the mean are again normally distributed. So the rules of normal distribution, that is the percentage of values within one standard error and within two standard error, applies to these means also because they are normally distributed. This is known as sampling distribution. So for single mean, Z is defined as, Z is equal to the difference between that particular mean from the population mean divided by the standard error. And standard error here is standard deviation divided by under root n. So this is the Z statistics for single sample. And the null hypothesis here, I'll talk about null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis today after a few slides. The null hypothesis here is that this mean or this sample mean is equal to the population mean. It means that the difference between the sample mean and population mean is zero. This is the null hypothesis when there is single sample mean. When there are two sample means and we are interested in difference between two means. So the Z statistics for difference between two means is the difference between those two means divided by this पर्टिकुलर कैलकुलेशन, दिस यू नो वी डिस्कस्ड इट प्रीवियसली, एंड नल हाइपोथेसिस हियर इज दैट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू मीन्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, विच मीन्स दैट द फर्स्ट मीन is equal to the second mean, then only the difference will be zero. So this is the Z statistics for two means, or the difference between two means. Then Z statistics for single proportion. So Z statistics for single proportion is actually this. And if we solve this further, the formula becomes this. That is, the difference between that single proportion from the population proportion divided by the square root of p into q divided by under root n. This is the Z statistics for single proportion. And the null hypothesis here is that this single proportion is equal to the population proportion, or in other terms, the difference between these two proportions is zero. When there are two proportions, we are interested in difference between those two proportions. The Z statistics is the difference between two proportions divided by this value. And the null hypothesis here is that the difference between two proportions is equal to zero. That is, the first proportion is equal to second proportion. This is the null hypothesis. Then there is something known as correlation coefficient. The Z statistics for correlation coefficient is given as Z is equal to hypotenuse of the correlation coefficient of that sample minus the inverse of hypotenuse of the population correlation divided by under root 1 by n minus 3. And the null hypothesis here is that there is no difference between the correlation coefficient of a sample and the population correlation coefficient. So this is about the sampling distribution and Z statistics. Any questions, students, up till now? I think we can continue. The next topic today for today is hypothesis testing. So our belief of what is true, that is what we expect to be correct, is known as hypothesis. So before undertaking any study, there is a hypothesis. Because of that hypothesis, because we want to prove that hypothesis, we undertake study. So that hypothesis is denoted by H1, and it is also known as alternate hypothesis. Opposite of alternate hypothesis is known as null hypothesis, and it is denoted as H0. So we undertake a particular study and analyze it statistically to either accept or reject the null hypothesis. The example here is, if the hypothesis is that alcohol causes liver cell injury, and we want to prove this, we want to undertake a particular study to prove over this hypothesis. So the alternate hypothesis for this particular study will be, the H1 will be, that alcohol causes liver cell injury. And what is the null hypothesis? S0 is that alcohol does not cause liver cell injury. So this is H0 and H1. H0 is null hypothesis and H1 is alternate hypothesis. And we conduct a particular study, and these are the results. If, for example, let us say the true situation is that the null hypothesis is true and the inference of our study is also that null hypothesis is true. So we accept the null hypothesis, and this is the correct result of our study. There is no error. And the other situation is, let us say if the true situation was that alternate hypothesis is true, and the inference of our study is that the alternate hypothesis is true. So since alternate hypothesis is true, we reject the null hypothesis, and this is the correct result. There is no error in this. This is the third situation. If the true situation is that the null hypothesis is true, but the inference of our study is that the alternate hypothesis is true, so there is error in results of our study, and this error is known as type 1 error, which is also known as alpha. And alpha is usually kept at 0.05 or 5% in the medical research and studies. It may be different for other fields. The next situation is, let us say if the true situation was that alternate hypothesis was true, but the inference of our study is that the null hypothesis is true. So we have committed an error, and that error is known as type 2 error. It is also known as beta, and the beta is usually kept at 0.2 or 20%. So these are type 1 and type 2 errors, which are possible as a consequence of a particular study. So type 1 versus type 2 error. In medical science, type 1 error is more dangerous. Why? Because rejection of an otherwise true null hypothesis may lead to acceptance of spurious association between two factors of a cause of disease. And in drug trials, type 1 error is more dangerous because higher efficacy of one drug over another may be accepted while it is not true. So this is the comparison of type 1 and type 2 error. Then there is something known as power of study. So power of study is the situation when the alternate hypothesis is true, and the inference of our study is that alternate hypothesis is true. So this is the power of study. So power of study is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis. That this probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is false. It is false. And you are rejecting it. You are doing the right thing. You are rejecting it because it is false. And this is the power of study. Mathematically, it is 1 minus beta, because beta was here in this cell. So it is 1 minus beta, and it is commonly kept at 80% because beta was 20%. So 1 minus 0.2 is 0.8, that is 80%. So power of study usually in medical science, it should be at least 80%. Power of study can be estimated before the study is undertaken, or after the study has been completed. You can either way, you can decide power of study and then undertake your research, or you can calculate the power of study after your research has been done. So any questions up till now? So this is end of today's lecture.